My name is Dr. Katie East. I'm a forensic anthropologist, bioarchaeologist, and science communicator. For my day job, I work as a forensic anthropologist in the arena of past counting. That means I carry out forensic analyses to help identify American service members who are missing from past military conflicts. My work focuses primarily on World War II, and I work as part of a team that combines DNA, historical, artifactual, and skeletal analysis to help identify these service members and return them to their families. My team specializes in really complex cases like aircraft crashes and battlefield losses. And because of that, we excel at resolving commingling and reconstructing circumstances around death. Over the 6 years I've worked for this team, I've worked on hundreds of really complex skeletal cases. And in my past life, I was a bioarchaeologist. My research and training focused on biochemical analyses of human remains, and I've worked on excavations or analyzed human remains from Egypt, Greece, Ireland, Canada, and the United States, dating back as far as the Paleolithic period. I've always been fascinated by shared human experiences across time and space and how these can be gleaned from the skeleton. So for my dissertation research, I decided to examine one of the most universal of human experiences, dying. Now, despite the universal nature of this experience, we don't actually know a lot about what it's like to die. So I turned to 2,000-year-old mummies from Egypt and modern people from Florida to figure out what it's like to die and if that differs between individuals. Of course, this isn't easy. We can't just ask people who have been through it, and archaeological remains don't tell us how someone felt about something. So I turned to stress hormones, specifically cortisol. And cortisol is released in the body in response to psychological and biological stressors. And I extracted these stress hormones from human hair, which records monthly averages of stress hormone experience. And what I found was that people who are dying have higher levels of stress hormones than people who are living. And that's probably not surprising. But what is interesting is that people dying today have stress hormone levels that are just as high, if not higher, than people who died in the past. What this means is that dying is stressful. And it means that dying has remained stressful despite our advancements in technology and medical treatment. But it's not all bad. In a smaller side study, I found that individuals who were dying in the 1900s, well, they also had high levels of stress at the end of life, but they showed mild improvement when they entered the hospital. Now, this is significant because medical treatments at the time couldn't cure these individuals and could not even alleviate all of their symptoms, which means that it wasn't medical treatment that was leading to an improvement in stress levels, it was care. And my hope is that this study of the past can help to inform present and future care of dying people.